So you were on The Electric Company for quite a while. How does it feel to be back in children's television now?
You know, I love it. And you know, it's an animated show. So it's really voice work. It's not like live actors. And it is a very special show in the sense that it's about a real little girl, little Mexican-American girl with a family who lives in a very multicultural neighborhood and who has a little friend. And let me say, this is taking diversity to a new plane. There's a little deaf boy whom I have met and taken pictures with. He looks like the little boy in Jerry Maguire with the glasses. Remember him? And he is deaf. He signs. He reads lips. And he speaks clearly. And when you see that little character in one of the episodes, that's the little deaf boy speaking for that character. So Sprout has taken diversity to do, you know, just up into the clouds somewhere. It's fabulous.
So how do you help Nina navigate her culture and her childhood?
First of all, I'm a very contemporary kind of Grammy. I'm called Abuelita, which translated means little grandma. And she does yoga.
Oh, good.
And she always lassos Nina into doing positions and stuff, every show, every episode. And more than that, she's the one who makes adventures when there aren't any. She somehow makes magic sometimes when there isn't any. She will, for instance, when the museum is closed and Nina gets upset, she says, well, you know what? Let's go into our garage and see what we find there. Make our own museum. And with that, Nina finds out a lot about the family history, because they're Mexican, and artifacts from Mexico. And that's the kind of tack that this show takes. It's fabulous. It's real. It's authentic. And it's not noisy, but it's fun. I mean, it's not a utopian kind of, aren't we wonderful? Hello, little girl. I hate it when people speak that way to children anyway. None of that stuff. Nina has her own personality. She's strong, and she's sometimes headstrong. And so it's about children. I think children will love it.
It sounds so fun, and like you say, so much for children to take away from that.
And more important, too, as important, not more important, is that the families will watch with them and get some clues on how to deal with children when it's a rainy day, for instance. What do you do? Well, just look at these shows and see how Abuelita solved that problem. It's marvelous.
And she does solve it, I'm sure.
Of course she does. Of course she does.
SAG Lifetime Achievement Award, Oscar, Grammy, Emmy. I mean, you are so awarded, I guess is the correct word. Anything else on your list of accomplishments?
Oh, you haven't heard.
Otherwise, what? Tell me.
You haven't heard. I'm being honored this December by the Kennedy Center Honors.
Congratulations.
Yeah, it's pretty fabulous. That is the pinnacle. I mean, you just, other than the Nobel Peace Prize, it doesn't get any better.
Well deserved, I'm sure. You'll have many fans cheering you.
Thank you so much.
Now, I have a question I just have to ask. You have so much energy. You look wonderful. You're so vibrant. What's your secret to healthy living, longevity, youthfulness? Please tell us.
You know, I'm asked that so much. So much of it is DNA, honestly. I've always been like this. I'm more this way than ever because this is the third act of my life. I don't know how long I'm going to be around. And I mean, I have to be realistic about that, or you should be. And smell the roses, for God's sake. You know, cherish every moment. Love your family. Get over those resentments and stuff. Just live the happiest life you can. It's not a secret. It's just live your life and appreciate it. Think of how wonderful those good moments are. Put the bad moments away, they're done. Anyway, no regrets. Regrets is a waste of time. Don't do that.
So many lessons to take away from you, Rita Moreno. Thanks so much for joining me. I'm Stephanie Stevens.